start the 2018 Convocation of Academic Excellence. Please join me in another round of applause for this beautiful opening music by the TCU Symphony. As a person with very little, well, actually no talent, it is amazing to watch these student musicians, and especially under the leadership of our maestro, Dr. Herman Gutierrez, and he just does an amazing job with our student musicians. Formerly known as Honors Convocation, today's event has been newly christened to celebrate academic excellence across the entire Texas Christian University campus. Thank you to our gracious host, the John B. Roach Honors College, for organizing the Convocation for Academic Excellence. Today, we highlight the achievements of many at TCU, including faculty, graduate students, undergraduate students, and others who have earned a variety of distinguished awards. We're also very excited and honored to welcome Colonel Shane Kimbrough, the Cecil H. and Ida Green Honors Chair, as our keynote speaker. And Dr. Snow will introduce Colonel Kimbrough more thoroughly to you later. But suffice it to say, the best asset of this astronaut is that he's also a TCU parent. That's probably his hardest job, too. I would also like to recognize members of our Board of Trustees who are with us here today. Trustee Amy Bailey and her husband, Tull. Trustee Kenneth Huffman and his wife, Jean. And Emeritus Trustee John Rhodes and his wife, Jean. Thank you for being with us today. And now we are honored to continue to showcase academic excellence in the fine arts. The TCU Symphony Orchestra has been selected as an honor group for the Texas Music Educators Association Convention. This convention is the largest recruiting event for music schools across the country. The group will perform at the convention in San Antonio in 2019. Once again, please help me welcome the TCU Symphony Orchestra under the direction of Dr. Herman Gutierrez as they perform Verano Porteño for strings by Astro Piazzolla.
Good morning and welcome. I'm Dr. Diane Snow. I'm Dean of John B. Roach Honors College. I'm so happy to see you all here with us today to celebrate academic excellence at TCU. How about one more round of applause for this spectacular. As hosts for this wonderful event, we have been tirelessly toiling over the last few months together. So I want to give congratulations to all the people who worked so hard to make this possible. Please a round of applause for the honors staff and faculty who worked so hard. Join me now as we venture into space. Although not for the first time, TCU has been in space before with a green honors professor, William MacArthur, parent of TCU alums Meg and Kate MacArthur. He carried a TCU flag during his spaceflight. Today, in our second walk down NASA Lane, we welcome Green Honors Chair Colonel Shane Kimbrough, father of TCU student Taylor Kimbrough, here today, a sophomore majoring in motion sciences. Colonel Kimbrough is one of us. He was born in Plano, Texas, although he spent his young years in Atlanta. He received his Bachelor of Science degree in Aerospace Engineering from the U.S. Military Academy at West Point in 1989 and entered the U.S. Army Aviation School. He then served in Operation Desert Storm, among other military duties. In 1998, he earned a Master of Science degree in Operations Research from the Georgia Institute of Technology and was a professor of mathematics in the Military Academy. Colonel Kimbrough then began his impressive history with NASA. In 2000, he was a flight simulation engineer. In 2004, he was selected as an astronaut and completed his first spacewalk in 2008. And yesterday, I and the students learned all about spacewalking. Very dangerous. He spent 16 days in space where he conducted two spacewalks. In 2016, on Expeditions 49 and 50, Colonel Kimbrough performed four spacewalks, amassing a total of 189 days in space. He's received many awards and honors, too many for me to list here today, and he knows firsthand what it means to seek and achieve academic excellence. I can't think of a better individual to be here with us today at the Honors Convocation of Academic Excellence. Please help me welcome Colonel Shane Kimbrough.
So much for letting me be part of this convocation ceremony. It's an honor to be back at TCU. It's an honor to be a TCU dad, as was mentioned earlier. And it's just great to celebrate this day of academic excellence with you. So thanks for letting me be a part of that. As I look across the audience, I see many people from the millennial generation, right? Yep, I see you. All right, you guys know that your generation is the first generation that's going to put people on Mars. Well, after Matt Damon, of course. But you're going to be the first real people to put people on Mars. So that's pretty exciting. You guys up for that, I hope. That'll be a challenge that we work over the next few decades to get your generation to another planet. As you may have guessed, I've been blessed with many incredible experiences, incredible, dangerous, exhilarating even, throughout my career as an Army officer and an astronaut. So many experiences that led me to the point of asking, how did I get here? Why me? How did I get to this point in time? So let me try to describe one of those experiences to you that I've just experienced fairly recently. The pressure gauge on the hatch reads 0.5 psi. It's time for me to open the hatch and venture out into the vastness and vacuum of space. I've been in my spacesuit now for about 2.5 hours. By the end of the day, it's going to be about 11 hours. That's 11 hours you can't touch your face, if you've ever thought about that. I'm traveling over 17,000 miles an hour, orbiting the Earth every 90 minutes. My first task is to connect my safety tether, very important. My second task is to connect my crewmate's safety tether, also very important. As I float out of the space station's airlock in my 300-pound spacesuit, I'm quickly overwhelmed by the stunning beauty and serenity of our home planet Earth. It's tough to focus on the task at hand at this moment, as you might imagine, when you're experiencing sensory overload of your brain and your heart. I'm kidding. After a few minutes of settling down, I get to work. The spacesuit I'm wearing is now my personal spaceship. It has everything I need to survive. It has air, water, communications, and even cooling. The suit also protects me from the 400-degree temperature swings that I'm going to experience every 45 minutes in the orbit that we're in outside of the space station. Some of these resources in my backpack or spacesuit have to be managed very carefully in order to make sure we have enough to last the 6 or 7 hours that we're going to be outside of the space station. Oh, by the way, sending people out into the vacuum of space is the most dangerous thing we ever ask any astronaut to do. So the phrase that's gone through my head on the many spacewalks that I've done now, at that moment when I get outside, is, I'm spacewalking. How did I get here? Seriously, how did I get here? So let me try to paint a picture of how I think I got there for you as we spend a little time together today. I grew up in an Army family. We moved all over the place. As a kid, I even went to elementary school most of my years in Germany. I was not blessed with many of the resources you think typically lead to success. But what I did do is I learned to integrate into many different environments, different cultures, different experiences of honoring different societies. So I think that's a really beneficial thing that I was able to do. Additionally, my parents taught me about priorities and keeping priorities in the correct order. Now, the anchors of my life are faith and family. And I honestly believe I've been successful because I keep those tenets at the forefront of my life. My jobs have all been very important, don't get me wrong, but at the end of the day, they're just jobs. Try to remember that, especially young folks, as you're heading out into the workforce. My experience shows that relationship building and team building are the critical pieces of any organization or family. I learned early on that taking care of people is absolutely the most important thing in any kind of group setting, all right? And definitely a part of leadership. It's tough, it takes time, but it's absolutely worth it and truly rewarding. I think our former First Lady, the late Barbara Bush, said it eloquently when she's talking about other people. And she says, quote, "The most important yardstick of your success will be how you treat other people," end quote. I couldn't agree more. So how did I get here? What gave me the edge that I needed to be successful academically, athletically, even socially, professionally? As I tell many people, I was never the smartest person in any of my classes. I was never the best athlete on any of my teams. But I guarantee you I worked harder than anyone else. And that was really kind of the edge, I think, that allowed me to be successful. Now, this didn't always correlate to getting an A on a test or catching the winning touchdown pass in a big football game. But I was able to accomplish things that no one ever thought I was going to accomplish, even myself. I always wanted to do things that people didn't think I could do. Are some of you like that? I hope so. Whether you're like that or not, blow people away about what you're going to accomplish in your life. Surprise them, make them be like, are you kidding me? You did that? Those are cool moments in your life. Don't just cruise through school or cruise through life. Your family, your friends, and even society in general demand your absolute best. Now, somehow God wired me in a way that I was geared to exceed expectations in everything I did. I know everybody's not like that, but that's kind of the way I've been wired. I've been very fortunate. I wanted to do the right thing, even when no one is watching. Will some of you be like that? I hope so. Now, don't think for a second that anything you've read in my bio or have heard about my life has been easy. All right, it's taken a lot of hard work, a lot of long days, long weeks, long months, long years of training and sacrifice, a lot of family sacrifices. I've had medical setbacks, other things and trials and tribulations that a lot of people go through in life. Difficulties and hardships are going to play in your life as well. But what I've learned, certainly through the tough times, although they test you, They're going to make you stronger and better on the other side. Now, have you ever wanted to be something or part of something that's bigger than yourself? I certainly hope so. If not, it's not too late, all right? I've been fortunate enough to serve and invest in other people for most of my life. That looks a little different for a lot of people, but it's happened in my job, in my family, in my community, all over the world. Investing in others has actually become one of my passions because it takes me out of the equation. All right? It puts organizations and the mission and companies and even our nation in front of myself. For me, serving others keeps everything in the proper perspective. Now, this started for me back in my high school days, believe it or not, like some of you. Many of you are part of service projects or mission projects around the world and have been or will be, and those are amazing. All right, as you know, TCU provides incredible opportunities for students to go all over the world and truly influence people and touch lives. Never did I think the seeds of servanthood that were planted in me back in my high school days would reap so many benefits even today. If you think about it, speaking of being part of something bigger than yourself, my entire Army career was spent serving our nation. And if you take that to another level, my career as an astronaut was actually spent serving all of humanity. Wow. And what an honor for me to have those responsibilities and to take them head on. I'm so honored to be able to do that. Again, how did I get here is the question I keep coming back to. I trust all of you will have the satisfaction of serving others. And if you're lucky, I hope it's going to become a way of life for you like it has been for me. Now, from my West Point days, as you probably are aware, I developed an intense sense of duty, honor, and country. And we had to memorize a lot of things shortly after arriving to the military academy, but one thing we had to memorize that I actually still remember is the cadet prayer. And this is something I've had in the back of my mind ever since those early days back in 1985 when I showed up. And I want to share with you my favorite part of the cadet prayer. It goes like this. Encourage us in our endeavor to live above the common level of life. Make us choose the harder right instead of the easier wrong. And never be content with a half-truth when the whole can be one. I'm going to repeat that again. Encourage us in our endeavor to live above the common level of life. Make us choose the harder right instead of the easier wrong, and never be content with the half-truth when the whole can be one. And my kids have heard this over and over. Sorry, Taylor. But I think it speaks volumes on how we should live our lives and how we should treat other people. So in closing, that's how I got here. Relentless work ethic and serving others allowed me to accomplish things, so many more things than I ever imagined. Doors continue to open for me, and I look forward to the next how did I get here moment. College students, I know there's plenty of you out there. It's time. All right, it's time for you to determine what your passion is. It's time for you to press towards goals that you think right now are unattainable. Stay the course through the good times and the bad. Surround yourselves with good people and do things the right way, with character, with integrity, with respect, and with honor. It's time for you to find your spacewalk moment. What's going to be your story 10, 20, 30 years from now? Your story doesn't have to look like mine, and I hope it doesn't. I hope it's something so unique and so different that it's just going to blow everybody away. But I hope that each one of you challenges yourself every day. Do things you never thought were possible. Have a positive influence on all of humanity. And do everything with a sense of humility. I wish you all the very best and look forward to hearing about your how did I get here moments in the future. Thank you very much and go Frogs.
Thank you, Colonel Kimbrough. My name is Dr. Andrew Schoolmaster, and I'm the Dean of the Ad-Grant College of Liberal Arts. Selection as a senior scholar is a high honor. Each student listed in your convocation program is viewed by faculty as the highest achieving graduating senior in a department. As the names of the students who have been selected are read, would each of those whose name is called please stand and remain standing until the names of all those selected from your college have been read. I now have the privilege of recognizing the 2018 Departmental Senior Scholars in the Ed Rand College of the Liberal Arts. John Manukian in Anthropology. Sadie Scott Martinson, Criminal Justice. Ting Kui Duan and Ben Sesnich in Economics. Haley Zablotsky in English, Kendra Lara in Geography, double-dipping, Kendra Lara in History. She sends her regards. She is in study abroad in Europe, back to Maine. Hannah Richstein, Modern Language Studies, Dylan Barth, Philosophy, Ryan DeTamble, and Amy Wheeler, in political science, Brendan Voss, religion, Ollie Richardson, in sociology, and Megan McCracken, Spanish and Hispanic studies. And now, Associate Dean Chip Stewart.
Thank you, Dean Schoolmaster. I'm thrilled to announce the 2018 Senior Scholar from the Bob Schieffer College of Communication. From the Communication Studies Department, Michael Fellers and Megan McCracken. From the Film, Television, and Digital Media Department, Weston McFarland. From the Journalism Department, Elizabeth Campbell. And from the Strategic Communication Department, Christy Cole and Justin Rubenstein.
My great honor to introduce the 2018 Senior Scholars in the College of Education. They are Aaron Dianas and Maddie Jungle. Now it's my pleasure and honor to introduce Dean Ann Helmer.
It is also my honor to introduce the 2018 Senior Scholars in the College of Fine Arts. Brooke Wong from Graphic Design, who could not be with us today. Callie Welsh from Interior Design and Fashion Merchandising. Christiane Cato from the School for Classical and Contemporary Dance. Shelby Johnson from the School of Art. M.K. Rapplinger from the School of Music. And Alex Venn from the Department of Theater. Congratulations and welcome. And now let me introduce Dean Phil Hartman.
My pleasure to introduce the Senior Scholars from the College of Science and Engineering. They are Courtney France and Amal Khan, biologist. Chris Sinker, chemistry and biochemistry. Luke Reddick, computer science, Delaney Clark, applied geosciences, Stephen Christopher Colbert, engineering, who cannot be with us, Alec Panner, Lindsay, environmental sciences, Sienna Olbert, geology, Tin Duan, mathematics, Nicole Benedict, nutritional sciences, Hannah Richstein, physics and astronomy, Courtney Favaloro, and Zach Wade, psychology.
And Health Sciences. Laura Ryans from the Davis School of Communication Sciences and Disorders. Emily Bowe and Nicole Hicks from Kinesiology. Jennifer Goldsberry, Delaney Poppin, and McKinnon Roth from Nursing. And Farron Berry from Social Work.
Jacob Chalet and Ben Sensenick from Finance. Kevin Dawson from Information Systems and Supply Chain Management. Michael Drake from Management, Entrepreneurship, and Leadership. And Cameron Schwab from Marketing.
This is a federally funded program which helps qualified juniors and seniors prepare for graduate study and ultimately to go on to pursue a PhD. Students conduct research with a faculty mentor and participate in a variety of other scholarly and cultural activities. Each student's research project and faculty mentor is listed in the program. As I read the names of the McNair Scholars, would each of those who have been called please stand and remain standing until all names have been read. This year's Ronald E. McNair Scholars are Isaiah Alexander, Entrepreneurial Management, Michael Carroll, Sociology, Ariana Cervantes, Psychology, Crystal Molina Lamili, Psychology, Melissa Moriera, Spanish Education, Chris Rios, Journalism, Nikki Romina, Criminal Justice Psychology, James Sang, Math Education. Tariah Stubblefield, Social Work. Hector Villegas, Biology and Chemistry. And Jessica Yates, Biology. Please join me in congratulating you.
Across the university have selected two master's students as the winners of the 2018 Outstanding Thesis Awards. The winners are Brittany White in the Department of History and Jeffrey Gasson in the Department of Psychology. Faculty faculty members in PhD granting departments across the university have selected two PhD students as winners of the 2018 Outstanding Dissertation Awards. The winners are Lisa Barnett in the Department of History and Jordan White in the Department of Psychology. And at last Friday's three-minute thesis competition, faculty, judges, and audience members were unanimous in their selection of the 2018 three-minute thesis award winner. And that is Jessica Dinsmore in the Department of Speech Pathology. Now Provost Donovan will present this year's nominees and recipients of the faculty awards.
Morning, everybody. Each year, I have the pleasure of recognizing faculty who have achieved excellence in teaching and scholarship, and have been recognized by their colleagues for their dedication to our academy. To be acknowledged by one's peers as an outstanding teacher or an exceptional scholar is a significant honor. The Dean's Teaching Awards and the Dean's Research and Creativity Awards are particularly noteworthy because faculty nominate, review, and recommend fellow faculty. The final selection is then made by the academic deans. The three recipients of each award will be presented a certificate of achievement and a check for $2,500. We'll do first the Dean's Teaching Award for 2018. Will the nominees please stand as your names are called and remain standing so that we may congratulate you as a group? Dr. Kirby Alexander from the College of Education. Dr. Lane Craig from English. Dr. Laura M. Mee from Supply Chain Management in the Dean School of Business. Ms. Allison C. Owen, Mathematics, the College of Science and Engineering. Ms. Irmgard Payne from Communication Sciences and Disorders in the Harris College of Nursing and Health Sciences. Dr. Lisa van der Linden from Anthropology in the Advent College of the Liberal Arts. Dr. Paul Witt, Communication Studies from the Bob Schieber College of Communication. And Dr. Jessica Gazella from Dance in the College of Fine Arts. Let's acknowledge these wonderful teachers. Be seated. Thank you. The winners of the 2018 Dean's Teaching Awards are Ms. Irmgard Payne, Dr. Lisa van der Linden, and Dr. Jessica Zeller. Stage, please, so we can give you your award. Irmgard Payne. Lisa. Would the 2018 Dean's Research and Creativity Award nominees please stand as your names are called, and again, please remain standing so that we can congratulate you as a group. Dr. Danielle M. Remo, Communication Science and Disorders in the Harris College of Nursing and Health Sciences. Dr. Hatch to Catherine Coleman, Strategic Communication, the both Chief of College of Communication. Dr. Robin Griffin from the College of Education. Dr. Blake Estill from Philosophy, the Agran College of Liberal Arts, Humanities Division. Dr. John M. Holbrook from Geology, the College of Science and Engineering. Dr. Max Crockmell from History in the Agran College of Liberal Arts, Social Sciences. Dr. Nina Martin from Dance in the College of Fine Arts. Dr. David S. Preston from Information Systems in the Nina School of Business. Congratulations to these wonderful scholars. And the winners of the 2018 Dean's Research and Creativity Awards are Dr. Catherine Coleman, Dr. Max Bruckner, and Dr. Nina Martin.
Enjoy your day.